All right, if you're watching this video, you're probably trying to figure out how to add a calculated field to a pivot table. So I'm going to show you that, but first we're going to try to start at the beginning so we can understand the process. We're looking here at the raw data that I'm going to do the pivot table on. Obviously, I kept it really simple so that we don't get distracted. And what this is a table of sample of salaries and the number of years of college that the people have taken that have these corresponding salaries. Like any table of raw data, this is only so useful. What you want to do is create a pivot table with it so you can figure out what the data is telling you. In order to do that, I'm going to go to data and do pivot table. There's lots of different ways to do these pivot tables, but I'm just going to do it in one particular way just because I think it's easier to show it to you this way. I'm going to put the years as the rows. And then I'm going to put make the values the salary. But if you watch, I'm going to actually make it the average of salaries because that's going to work more for what we're going to use the calculated field for. Now the salaries got added in this horrible number format, so I'm going to change it to number and then decrease the decimals by 2. What I want to do with this data is I want to say, how much salary are you getting per year of college at this point? And in order to do that, you have to divide the salary averages that I have in column B by the number of years of college that I have in A. In order to do that, you want to use a calculated field. So go down to values, you're going to add a field, and you're going to select the bottom option, which is calculated field. You scroll down so you can see it. Let's name it something that is meaningful instead of calculated field one. So let's say salary per year of college. How's that? And the formula is going to be salary divided by years of college. And this part's a little clunky, I think, because I can't use my mouse and go up here and click in it. I have to remember the field values. The one that's salary I can see because it's up here, but the year of college, I'm not sure if that's exactly what the raw data said, so let me go to it, years of college. So I have to type that in as my other field. And it doesn't work. Whenever you have spaces, I knew that wasn't going to work because I practice this, hopefully, of course. This actually isn't working because there's spaces in the name, so you have to tell Sheets, look, this is a string of characters that starts here and it ends here. So put in that little single quote sign, and then you see it figured it out. And again, it put in that ugly number format. So just tell it it's a number and that you only want one decimal point by clicking the decrease twice. And here you have it. So you have a pivot table with summarized data from the table before and a calculation on the summarized data. This calculation on the right isn't calculating from the raw data. It's calculating from the summary of the raw data that you created. So there's infinite combinations that you can do here, average, sum, and then the calculation of those can be anything as well. Hopefully that helped walk you through the basics of entering a calculated field into a Google spreadsheet.